more wrinkles 2 years post blepharoplasty, and CO2 laser resurfacing. I am 30 years old. I had a lower lid blepharoplasty and CO2 laser resurfacing procedure 2 years ago. I am now 30 years old and have significantly more wrinkles than before the procedure, mostly seen when I smile, but they can also be seen when I'm not smiling, when the light hits just right. Is there any type of cream, such as Retin A or similar, that can be used to help the creepy wrinkled skin that is under my eyes right now? Other recommendations? Thank you for your time.
Thank you for your question. You are 30 years old, and 2 years ago you had blepharoplasty and CO2 laser, and you believe that your skin has become thin, wrinkled, and more crepey than before. So you're looking for options, and this is something that we have seen for many years. Not necessarily specific to one type of laser, but just to go over a little bit of the history of the thought process of why ablation is a part of the rejuvenation of skin. For many years, pre-lasers, the standard was chemical peel. So we would have chemical peels at superficial, medium, or deep. And the idea was that if you took away a certain level of skin up to the upper levels of the dermis, then the new skin that comes in has an area of of collagen called the grenz zone, and it would be covered by fresher, nicer looking skin. Now in the mid-90s, the CO2 laser became one of the first lasers to become the step beyond chemical peels. And one of the key elements of that was the thermal energy delivery, which provided a certain amount of tightness and a certain amount of collagen stimulation. And from that point forward, there has been many different permutations of different types of lasers, variations on the CO2 laser, and with the ultimate goal of improving the appearance of wrinkles and generating more collagen. Now, a certain group of people, even though they got an improvement in wrinkles, I noticed their skin still got a little bit thin. Now, moving on to this time frame, I've always asked my patients about their lifestyle in addition to the solutions we offer. We have to understand, are there factors that can be contributing to causing the skin to become thin? These factors include lifestyle aspects such as smoking, excess sun exposure, not enough sleep, stress. All of those things are factors that can contribute to the skin becoming thinner. Now, that being said, in terms of alternatives for improving skin quality under the eyes, when you feel like you can't really laser some more, a lot of our colleagues will keep using heat. Basically, laser energy is converting light energy to heat, and that heat induces a certain tissue response. So what we're doing now is focusing on regenerative medicine. And in our practice, we've been applying the material called platelet-rich plasma. This is a part of your own blood. We take your blood, we spin it, and we take the part that has the platelets and the growth factors that are necessary for healing. See, when you think about your healing, think of a cut. And a simple cut on your finger first becomes a little clot or a scab, and then the skin heals over. This healing process is due to the platelets and the growth factors in the serum. So, in other fields of medicine, in particular oral surgery and orthopedic surgery, the benefits of platelet-rich plasma for wound healing was already well established, and right now it is extremely popular for professional athletes to get injections of platelet-rich plasma for areas that get a lot of stress, impact, and inflammation. In aesthetic field, we have been now using this this platelet-rich plasma for many indications. We're using it for acne scars. We're using it for fine lines and wrinkles. In our hair loss division, we're actually combining this with acellular matrix to reverse and to thicken hair that is thinning. It's a remarkable technology that we have been developing over the past couple of years and now have had consistent results with it. So, platelet-rich plasma is one thing that we would consider doing for someone like yourself if you were to come to our practice. We'd be injecting it, we'd allow the skin to benefit from it. Usually we wait a couple of months, and then we would use some topicals. Topicals can be beneficial, but with a limitation. And so retinoids could be considered, but you have to be very, very careful about the strength and the type of retinoids that you use. So as an answer to your question, from my perspective, to help improve skin quality, the choices after you have exhausted the laser options become more and more limited. So platelet-rich plasma is something that we have leveraged quite well. And what's nice is that even as opposed to laser, in contrast to laser, when you get laser treatment, it is something that you don't necessarily want to do again anytime soon after you've done the laser, because you have to allow for months to a year of healing. Yet with platelet-rich plasma, we can re-inject somebody with platelet-rich plasma several times during the year and observe their benefit and then make a decision on whether or not it's worthwhile to try again. So consider that as an option. Reflect or look at what your lifestyle is about and see if there's any way you can improve your quality of life. There are other things that I also suggest to my patients that are more on the alternative medicine route, such as the use of fish oils and supplements. I do believe in the use of supplements, particularly when I listen to my patients about their diets and see what we can do to enhance or supplement. And then be patient. But I would not recommend necessarily additional lasering, but rather consider this regenerative medicine option of platelet-rich plasma. So I hope that was helpful, and thank you for your question.